I'm Paul Barton, and welcome to this quintuple piano lesson, which, you might have guessed, is divided into five parts. One, a recording of my new solo piano arrangement of Perpetuum Mobile by Simon Jeffs, a work he wrote for Penguin Cafe Orchestra. Two, about Simon Jeffs and the orchestra. Three, the new harmonic pedal technique used in this recording. Four, counting the time signature 15/8. Five, composing your own Perpetuum Mobile. Perpetuum Mobile, in the musical sense, describes a piece of music with a steady, continuous stream of notes, often in long, repeated patterns. The original version with the Penguin Cafe Orchestra is linked below. A few words about the pedaling in this recording. I jotted down this solo piano arrangement with the fourth harmonic pedal in mind, but it can be played with a sustain pedal, although the effects are different. Now, I'd like to play you my solo piano arrangement, which you can download as part of a free PDF for educational purposes from a link in the video info box below. Thank you. Perpetuum Mobile was composed by Simon Jeffes, a classically trained guitarist and composer who, around 1972, formed a group of like-minded chamber musicians, Penguin Cathy Orchestra. Many of us back in the 70s and 80s remember discovering newly emerging styles of contemporary music by composers such as Philip Glass, Steve Reich, John Adams in the USA, and the Penguin Cathy Orchestra in Britain had a similar minimalist feel to it, but with its own unique blend of influences such as folk, new age, ethnic, and so on. Simon Jeffes' piano music deserves to be better known. There's a link below to a piece from a solo piano album I think you'll enjoy. Penguin Cathy Orchestra were active for 24 years until Simon Jeffes passed away in 1997. After that, the Penguin Cathy Orchestra evolved in different ways. Some of the original members formed the orchestra that fell to earth. Links below to samples of their music. Jeff's son Arthur formed a band called Penguin Cathy and has been active in keeping his father's music alive, as well as recording and performing his own music. There's a link to Arthur Jeffes' music played on keyboard with violin below. The music of Penguin Cathy Orchestra has been used in films. For example, Perpetuum Mobile was used in the 2009 Australian animated film Mary and Max, so the music could be already familiar to you. I use the harmonic pedal in my recording to hold chords under the orange triangle while at the same time playing the Mobile part on top without the mixing and blurring you get with the sustain pedal. And it's simple to do. Press the pedal down to capture the chord like a photo. The harmonic sostenuto will hold everything you play until you release it to resonant half position, so it can be as short or as long as you like. We press the harmonic pedal down at the time we play the chord, which also has notes in the right hand too, notes we need to borrow to play the Mobile part, and quickly release to half position to play the Mobile part on top of the chord. Notice the chord and Mobile parts don't blur together. To show you what I mean, let's make things more difficult and widen the difference between the two effects. I'll play the Mobile part in staccato on top of the chord held with harmonic sostenuto. Can't get the traditional sostenuto to do this, as, frankly, the mechanical process of getting it to work is just much too slow to be useful in music at a fast tempo, and you don't get that extra glow of harmonic resonance in staccato. In music, the most common time signature is 4-4, or common time. Each bar divides evenly into two. composers today often write in uncommon time. An example of an uncommon time signature is quintuple time, which has 5 beats to a bar. 5/4 can be divided into 2s and 3s, but not regularly as it can in common time. A compound quintuple time signature is 15/8, the time signature of perpetuum mobile. 15/8 can be divided in various ways. It can be divided regularly in 3 groups of 5 quavers. In 5 groups of 3 quavers. Fifteen-eight gets really interesting when it has an irregular or additive metrical pattern. For example, 3 groups of 3 and 3 groups of 2 quavers. Three groups of 4 and a group of 3 quavers. Group of 4, then 3, then 2 groups of 4 quavers, which is the rhythmical meter of perpetuum mobile. Have you ever composed a piece of music? If not, and would like to have a go, this section is for you. Instead of starting with a melody, we're going to start with a time signature. You guessed it, 15/8. Here's an easy way to make a composition. No previous experience necessary. Cut up a sheet of paper into lots of squares. On each square, write a letter from A to G, 5 times each letter. When you get to C, write an extra 5 with a line above it to show it's the C an octave above the other one. Write lightly in pencil so you can't see the letters from the other side of the paper. Place the letters face down and shuffle them around like playing cards. Take 15 letters and place them in a row. On a sheet of manuscript paper, if you don't have a sheet, there's a blank sheet in the PDF you can print, write these 15 notes on the treble clef, just as dots, filling up one bar. Copy this bar, leaving a blank stave below until you've filled up the manuscript paper. Turn your dots into quavers in one of the irregular groups we looked at in section 4. Start with the meter, 4 plus 3 plus 4 plus 4, and later you can try the other meters, also even mix them. In the bass clef, copy the treble notes above, one octave below, in unison until you've completed 4 bars. Now, make a new pattern for the left hand. The left hand can play in unison with the right hand, but also have an independent part. Shuffle and select 15 more letters in the same way and write them down on the bass clef for 4 more bars directly under the treble clef, note for note. Now, try playing it. If you repeat this enough times, you're sure to get something completely unexpected you like the sound of. If the work of Simon Jeffs is new to you, I hope you'll follow the links below and listen to more of the music of this incredibly talented and original composer. I hope you find this video useful, and thanks for watching.